A very good morning and Om Shanti to all of you listeners. Welcome back to your own channel, and today we're going to talk about the 288th day of a godly blessing, where God is trying to tell us that the best method is to not look into other people's lives but to look into our own lives, and not to waste our time and follow whatsoever Bab Dada or Godfather has guided us to do and help him out to change this world. So let's see what does Baba have to say in today's blessing. Baba says, may you be a master Maryada Purushottam, in brackets, elevated being who follows the highest code of conduct. Maryada Purushottam means highest code of conduct which God has given us. Now we're going to explore that also. By following the highest code of conduct and making Bab Dada's task your aim. What is that aim? We're going to explore that too over here. So it is said, grind your own ingredients and you will feel intoxicated. So when somebody is making an intoxicating drink or an intoxicating cigarette mixture or anything, we call it tambaku or anything, what do? They make their own mixture, they fold it into a leaf and they start smoking it, right? They make their own mixture as per how much they can take. So here also God says, never let your vision fall on anyone else's income. Anybody who's earning a lot of income, he's got a lot of intoxication about the income or the post or the position on which he's received or whatsoever accomplishments that person has achieved in a university. Maybe he has scored the highest marks or has got distinction and has passed with laurels. So that person has got intoxication. God is saying, don't look at other people's intoxication. Look at your own. Create your own intoxication. Who are you? What qualities God has given you in this lifetime and what you're missing out on? Because if we are always praising others, then God also created us, right? What about praising ourselves? Praising ourselves doesn't mean ego. Praising the good qualities which God has given us is the right form of praise. So then God says, never let your vision fall on anyone else's income. Instead of making someone else's intoxication your aim, what do we then? Our eyes always fall onto other people who are doing better than us. Then what do? How do we avoid that? God says that instead of making someone else's intoxication your aim, make Bab Dada's virtues and task your aim. So Godfather and Brahma or Adam, God comes down on earth to purify Adam, and Adam along with Godfather then helps us children, to follow God's vision of turning this hellish world or turning this iron aged world or Kaliyuga, extreme Kaliyuga, into Satyuga, into the golden age on this very earth which used to exist earlier. So God says, help me out in this task instead of focusing on other people's virtues or values and other things and getting intoxicated into them or their lives and getting attracted to them. Be attracted to my aim and objective. Then God says, become Bab Dada's helper in destroying irreligiousness and establishing the religion of truth. So God comes down on earth to destroy irreligiousness. But do we have that irreligiousness within us, ourselves? If we have that within ourselves and we have got jealousy while looking at others, or we look down upon ourselves while looking at others, that, oh, he's so good, she's so better, I'm nothing in front of them, that is also creating negativity, impurity in our thoughts, and we are actually helping irreligiousness to propagate. So God says, don't do that, remove that irreligiousness and establish the religion of truth. Truth is that we are unique souls. You're unique, I am unique, and God has given us also those virtues which are maybe distinct and different from that other person whom we are praising so much. We need not do that. We need not praise our brothers and sisters, but praise God's virtues, God's values, instead of praising our brothers and sisters, which we have been doing for many, many births. God says, those who are destroying irreligiousness cannot do anything irreligious or break the divine codes of conduct. Getting jealous of somebody, feeling down by looking at somebody is also breaking the divine codes of conduct. Such souls are Master Maryada Purushottam, who stay in the highest code of conduct. They never cross that boundary or that Lakshman Rekha, who follow the highest code of conduct. So highest code of conduct is look at the father, don't look at it brother and sister. Now what is it to look in the father? What qualities, what virtues does Godfather have? That is what we learn at Brahma Kumaris every single day. What can we praise God of? Now it's not just about praising God, but God has given us to those qualities. We should praise those qualities too within us. But do we know them? We can only know what we have when we look at our own physical father, right? Your physical father's property is your own. So if your father has got a house, has got a car, you feel proud about it because they belong to you. Now, what does God the Father have which belongs to us? That is what we explore at Brahma Kumaris, which you are most welcome to visit and learn about. So have a blessed day and have a safe day. Om Shanti.